Now, let's see the drawbacks of Whittaker system of classification. There are several drawbacks. So, first drawback, he kept algae into three kingdoms. Okay? So, first drawback, three kingdoms are assigned to algae. What are those three kingdoms? Monera, Protista, and Plantae. Monera mein aap, you can take the example of blue green algae. Protista mein diatoms, dinoflagellates. And in case of Plantae, green algae, brown algae, red algae. So he assigned three kingdoms to Plantae, right? The another drawback is that slime molds do not fit in kingdom Protista. Slime molds do not fit in Protista. Besides this, he also gave archaebacteria, kept archaebacteria in the prokaryotic organisms. But archaebacteria, it shows lots of differences between from the prokaryotic or the bacterias. Prokaryotic cells of the bacteria or the prokaryotic organisms. So, archaebacteria shows many differences from prokaryotic organisms. And one very important drawback is that he did not give any place to viruses, no place to viruses. So these are the drawbacks of the Whittaker system of Whittaker kingdom system. Later another scientist came and he is known as Carl Woos. In 1994, what he did, he divided Monera into two kingdom. Carl Woos ने क्या किया? इन्होंने Monera को दो kingdom में, kingdom Monera था, इसको further divide किया दो kingdom में, and those two kingdoms are Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. Let's see what are the basis of the distinction between these two kingdoms. So first, on the basis of the cell wall, Archaebacteria mein kya tha? Cell wall is not made up of cellulose or peptidoglycan. So cell wall is neither cellulosic. Nor made up of peptidoglycan. Instead, it is made up of pseudomurine. Cell wall is made up of pseudomurine. Jabki Eubacteria mein kya tha? Cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan. Cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan, which is also known as murine. ठीक है? Next tha cell membrane. Next character is cell membrane. Cell membrane क्या है? Eubacteria में हमने देखा cell membrane is made up of lipid bilayer. इस तरीके से lipid bilayer से cell membrane बना होता है. और इनके जो टेल होते हैं दे आर नॉट अटैच विथ ईच अदर. ठीक है, इन दिस वे दे शो द टू लेयर्स एंड दीज टू लेयर्स इट इज नोन एज लिपिड बाईलेयर. जबकि आर्की बैक्टीरिया में क्या होता है, देर आर ऑल्सो टू लेयर्स प्रेजेंट, टू लेयर्स ऑफ द लिपिड आर प्रेजेंट बट देयर एंड्स आर their ends appears jointed. That's why it shows, it appears, it gives the appearance of the monolayer. So cell membrane has the lipid monolayer present. Now in case of archaebacteria, their fatty acid tails are branched. Here fatty acid tails are branched, whereas in case of eubacteria, fatty acid tails are unbranched. Right? Now, one more feature is histone proteins. So, इसमें जो है histone-like proteins are present. Stone-like proteins are present in case of archaebacteria, whereas they are absent in eubacteria. Now, these monolayers, these fatty acid tails, they are and connected with the bond that is ether bond. Here, the ether bond is present in case of cell membrane, and ester bond is present in case of cell membrane of the eubacteria. So these are certain distinct characteristics on the basis of which the Karl Voss divided the kingdom Monera into two kingdom, that is kingdom Archaebacteria and kingdom eubacteria. Now Karl Voss performed genetic analysis of different organisms present in different kingdoms, right? जितनी भी ऑर्गेनिजम्स, जस्ट टू क्लासिफाई द ऑर्गेनिज्म, व्हाट ही डिड, ही परफॉर्म जेनेटिक एनालिसिस ऑफ किसका जेनेटिक एनालिसिस परफॉर्म किया, ऑफ द डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर प्रेजेंट इन डिफरेंट किंगडम, क्योंकि इन्हीं को तो क्लासिफाई करना था ना, एंड ही हैड टू गिव द न्यूट सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन. सो फॉर दैट on the basis this genetic analysis which he performed of different organism, it was based on the study of the nucleotide sequences of 16S rRNA. Okay, so this genetic analysis which he performed was based on the nucleotide sequence of 16S rRNA genes. What is gene? 16S rRNA genes. Basically, genes, they are consist of the DNA. DNA has the ability, DNA kya hota hai? DNA has the ability to synthesize different types of the RNA by the process of transcription. So, basically, inhone isme kya hota tha? DNA, aise genes, aise DNA ko utilize karta hai, which has the capacity to perform, to synthesize this 16S rRNA. ठीक है, तो Karl Voss ने proper sequences जो है total proper sequences study की, सारे sequences की, and according to him the organisms of the all the kingdom present on the entire earth, they can be divided into six kingdom, right? And the organisms of these six kingdom, they can be placed into the three domains. So basically he gave a new taxonomic category. He provided a new rank to the organisms. Okay? So, and that is the highest category. That category, this domain is placed above the kingdom. तो अभी तक तो क्या था, किंगडम वॉज सपोज टू बी द हाइएस्ट कैटेगरी, नाउ द डोमेन हैज बिकम द हाइएस्ट कैटेगरी. सो ही गेव Karl Voss, व्हाट ही डिड, Karl Voss गेव ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ द स्टडी ऑफ द सीक्वेंसेज ऑफ 16S rRNA प्रेजेंट इन ऑल द ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑफ द ऑल द किंगडम्स, ही डिवाइडेड organisms into six kingdoms. So let's see what are those six kingdoms. Those six kingdoms are, जैसा हमने देखा कि मोनेरा को उन्होंने डिवाइड किया इन आर्की बैक्टीरिया, देन दिस इज द किंगडम आर्की बैक्टीरिया. अनदर वन, अनदर किंगडम इज किंगडम यू बैक्टीरिया. थर्ड किंगडम इज प्रोटिस्टा. Fourth one is fungi, and fifth kingdom is plantae, and the sixth kingdom is animalia, right? So he divided all the organisms in these six kingdoms. Now what extra things he did, he kept all the these kingdoms into three domains. ठीक है, तो उन्होंने क्या किया, इस kingdom को, kingdom आर्की bacteria को रखा आर्की में. he provided a new domain, that is a new category, that is domain which is placed, which has given the place above the kingdom, and this archaebacteria was kept in the domain archae, eubacteria was kept in the domain, eubacteria was kept in the domain bacteria, and the rest of the four kingdoms are kept in the domain eukarya. They all are eukaryotic organisms. So there are three domains. First is archae, second is bacteria, and third is eukarya. Now he told that all these three domains they arise from a common ancestor, and that common ancestor was named by him as the progenote. So according to him, all these domains, three domains, they arise from a common ancestor, and that common ancestor is known as progenote. अब विटिकर सिस्टम ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन की तरह, जस्ट लाइक द क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम ऑफ विटिकर, दिस क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम इज ऑल्सो बेस्ड ऑन द इवोल्यूशनरी रिलेशनशिप. ठीक है, इवोल्यूशनरी रिलेशनशिप, और दिस क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम ऑल्सो इंक्लूडेड फाइलोजेनी. ठीक है, सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम. इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर आई विल स्टार्ट टू डील विद द किंगडम, दैट इज मोनेरा. And we will discuss about the sole member of the kingdom Monera, that is bacteria, in detail. Thank you.